Minister responsible for Foreign Affairs, Immigration and Trade, the Honorable Paul E. Chet Green, CARICOM Ambassador and National Authorizing Officer, Mr. Clarence Henry, Youth Ambassador to CARICOM, Lyle Jackson, Ms. Barbara Williams, Deputy National Authorizing Officer and Member of the Diplomatic Corps, members of the Media Organizing Committee, exhibitors, vendors, and patrons, good afternoon. Over time, the importance of our CARICOM Alliance has been demonstrated in the way we unite. It has been demonstrated in our support for each other. It is seen in the way we share our vaccines that we would have received from international partners, how each of our leaders have called on our international leaders for improvements and support for small island developing states like ours. And today is no different as we celebrate with this CARICOM Friendship Day Street Fair. And to begin us this afternoon, we'll call Mr. Can Cordes, the Director of Culture, to bring us welcoming remarks.
Minister responsible for Foreign Affairs, Immigration and Trade, Honorable Paul E. Chet Green. CARICOM Ambassador, National Authorizing Officer, Mr. Clarence Henry. Youth Ambassador, Mr. Lyle Jackson. Deputy National Authorizing Officer, Ms. Barbara Williams. Members of the Diplomatic Corps, members of the Media Organizing Committee, exhibitors and patrons, good afternoon. Today is indeed a special day for all of CARICOM, as we celebrate yet another CARICOM Day. And for those of us who are unaware, this day is celebrated on the first Monday in July. This regional integration movement continues to grow in strength through strategies and policies for the togetherness and development of the people of the 20 member and associate member states. As is stated in its mandate, CARICOM promotes and supports a unified Caribbean community that is inclusive, resilient, competitive, sharing in economic, social, and cultural prosperity. It is that force that continues to provide opportunities for its people and represents our individual small island states as a single unit. At this time, I ask us all to pray for the safety of our brothers and sisters of our member states and the wider Caribbean. For those of us who are still severely affected by the COVID-19 pandemic that has strained our healthcare, slowed our development and economic growth. But more recently, the volcanic eruption with our brothers and sisters in St. Vincent. And even more recently, our brothers and sisters who are threatened and negatively impacted by the Hurricane Elsa. We stand with you. It is a proud day for us in Antigua and Barbuda as we celebrate with our Prime Minister, the Honorable Gaston Brown, as he assumes the chair of CARICOM. To our brothers and sisters, let us work together in support of our continued growth as a region. Today, in celebration of our Friendship Day, we have in excess of 25 vendors who will be displaying and selling marvelous works of art, skincare products and fashionable pieces, as well as food and clothing, all locally made by Antiguan and Barbudans and brothers and sisters of CARICOM. We must continue to support our own as we work towards a more attractive and resilient creative industry for potential world export market. As we make our way through the streets of St. John's, I ask that we do our part in limiting the spread of COVID. Wear your mask, watch your distance, and stay sanitized. I also want to thank the work of the staff of the Department of Culture, Mr. Lodat and his team, for working feverishly behind the scenes to make today a reality. Kudos to you. I welcome all to CARICOM Friendship Day Street Fair. In the words of Lord Nelson, all are we are one family. Have a great day.
Our thanks to Director of Culture, Mr. Can Cordes, for those welcoming remarks. We'll now have a dance presentation as we continue this afternoon's proceedings, and I'm sure you'll be entertained by the display that we'll have at this moment.
Thank you.
Ambassador to CARICOM, Mr. Lyle Jackson, to give us some remarks.
Minister for Foreign Affairs, Immigration and Trade, Mr. Paul Chet-Green. CARICOM Ambassador, National Authorized Officer, Mr. Clarence Henry. Ms. Barbara Williams, Deputy National Authorizing Officer, Member of the Diplomatic Corps. Members of the media, organizing committee, exhibitors, vendors, patrons, good afternoon. We're here today in the spirit of CARICOM. I'm proud to say today that this is the first of its kind across the region. This CARICOM Food Fair, and although we're in a pandemic, I first want to thank everyone, of course, for adhering to the protocols, but at the same time still showing up, social distancing, wearing your mask, sanitizing, just doing your part, of course, to keep us safe. Now, today, I'm here to promote the I Am CARICOM campaign. The I Am CARICOM campaign is a product of a meeting of the CARICOM ambassadors, and the idea is to, of course, push the identity of CARICOM, the spirit of oneness and unity. We are all separated by geography, but we are one because of choice, and we are one in spirit.
We say thanks to Mr. Lyle Jackson, Youth Ambassador to CARICOM, from right out of here, Antigua and Barbuda. And as we continue this afternoon, I'd just like to remind those who are gathered, all of our patrons, that we are still operating under our COVID guidelines, so you are required to wear your face masks properly, as well as to maintain the social distancing protocols under which we are guided. Thank you so much for that. And as we continue this afternoon, we'll invite none other than our Honorable Minister, E.B. Chet-Green, to bring us our feature address this afternoon as we continue to celebrate our CARICOM Friendship Day in this prestigious and inaugural way.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I recognize Youth Ambassador Jackson, Director of Culture, Kathy Cordes, CARICOM Ambassador, Dr. Clarence Henry, other members of the Diplomatic Corps, Caribbean citizens, residents here in Antigua, Barbuda, and of course, Antiguans and Barbudans. Let me wish you all, or join in wishing you all, a happy CARICOM Day when it comes around next Monday. But in the meantime, happy CARICOM Friendship Day, which is what we're here to celebrate today. In my capacity as Minister of Foreign Affairs, I could not miss this opportunity to speak on an occasion and a moment which I personally believe in. I'm talking of CARICOM, what it means to us as a people, sometimes misunderstood. But it ought to be understood and agreed that the only vehicle we as a region have to fight for on our behalf in promoting the interests of these Caribbean rocks, independent and non-independent countries, is CARICOM. In this pandemic period, I think the CARICOM integration process, fair to say, has strengthened, has deepened, as we begin or continue even to realize the interdependence of our existence. As we live through experiences of vaccine herd in our nationalism, as we work our way through the pandemic period with difficulties in rebuilding our economies, in protecting for the safety of our people, the value of CARICOM becomes even more glaring, more acceptable. And so, let me, at this stage, commend the Department of Culture and its leadership on the Kan Cordes for conceiving this very idea of a CARICOM Day of Celebration, Friendship Day. Let me thank all the vendors from the respective islands resident here in Antigua Barbuda for coming out in a show of solidarity and clearly a show of understanding of what CARICOM really means to all of us. I see the extension at today's gathering, a delegation from the Republic of Cuba. Not a Caribbean, not a CARICOM country, but a Caribbean country. And that for me speaks volumes to the understanding of the oneness of the Caribbean civilization and the need, I repeat for emphasis, the need for us to work more closely together. The Jamaica delegation, the Grenada delegation, Vincentian, all those who are here today, I say welcome and commend you to be here on this day, not well, of this initiative. And at the same time, encourage the Department of Culture to continue to build out on this brand. In this pandemic period, I believe that we have certain challenges. Numbers are not the issue today because social distancing and the like still apply. But the very fact that we're here to celebrate our existence, our Caribbean oneness, is a clear indication from St. John's, the bastion of CARICOM, the bastion of CARICOM, the strength, the strong point of CARICOM, the very importance of not only this day, but of the CARICOM movement. This occasion also comes at a very important and seminal time, as Antigua Barbuda assumed the chair of CARICOM, Prime Minister Brown, as of the first of this month, and for the next 6 months, will lead the CARICOM charge, not only in terms of our regional integration, CSM and other platforms, but in terms of CARICOM's view and vision of the world and the view they have of us. And so today, a very important day, a very auspicious day, as we pause to recognize who we are in time and space. And I encourage you once again, Mr. Cordes and your team, to continue to build out this day. It has great value. I can imagine in the post-pandemic period, next year, when this event comes to St. John's, or any other location across Antigua Barbuda, because you're not one of the persons who don't believe that everything must be held in St. John's. As a matter of fact, I want to throw an invitation out that next year's edition of this event takes place in the beautiful parish of St. Paul's, the most beautiful part of Antigua. And again, the idea is to show the oneness of Caribbean people as we display our culture, as we display all those elements that make us uniquely a people of global context and content. So again, to the Antiguan displays, CRISPR, souvenir vendors, food. I welcome you to this inaugural program of CARICOM Friendship Day and encourage the Antigua and Barbuda in particular to continue to embrace the oneness of the region. I will not go through all the spiel of the international relations and why a single common position in foreign affairs will be to our benefit. I think it is safe to say that our experience from this pandemic period points to us very clearly, or points us very clearly in the direction where the need for CARICOM, the importance of CARICOM, is understood by more persons today than the start of the pandemic a year ago. For the region, we have much to be thankful for. For the region, we have much more work to do. Issues of transportation, issues of trade, issues of health, of education, all of those regional platforms that have made us into a strong, resilient people. We need to revisit them, continue to build them, rebuild in some instances, and strengthen generally all of the institutions of CARICOM. So again, happy CARICOM Day when it rolls around Monday. But for today, let us celebrate the cultures, the food, the music, and all those things which make us uniquely a people worthy of global attention and recognition. I thank you.
Those who are joining us via virtual means across the region to join us here in Antigua and Barbuda next year as we continue to celebrate our uniqueness as islands and also all of our similarities that bring us together. We'll now have a fashion show, and this is going to be brought to us by the Dream Catchers Modeling Agency, and it will be powered by designs from Shireen Gillian. So please welcome them as they come and bring us this demonstration.
This is the car when we drive on the wrong park. This is the walk with the stock. I am character. When I see some member, I don't know how to do it. When I'm ready to participate, when I work with me, you see the car when we drive on the wrong park. You just have to walk with the stagger. Wrong walk it. Me just still a girl, me love her. Wrong target. Me see another one, me like got a wrong target. Car when we drive, you see the walk with the stagger. Me just still a girl, me love her. Me see another one, me like got a wrong target. What a wrong. Open on the globe. But me no 50. When you look in at me, I think me tipsy. You no look girl at night. Risky. Hold on, hear the mystery. Two on the road around. Tell them I'm not trusted. Me a stare upon a girl and me see a brother post it. The next day, him see a man a post it. So like a man in game. He never look it. That's why I'm not trying to look girl at night. See a girl me like, my ask her the age and the gender and then me pull out a flashlight. Take responsibility. It's me. Hold on. I can tell them something. Oh, sing it with me. Let me talk now. Drunk and cash over. Pass me the rug and we don't want to see that. Let me sing it. Drunk and cash over. Come on. Drunk and cash over. Pass me the rug and we don't want to. One drop. Two Mr. Rum car. Get things from my junk. Things from the home who can't take man for punk. Have a little thing when me want confront. Why it and I want vote for Donald Trump? If me never talk you with that thing some of them. Walk on with the elephant and him son. The youth says daddy never did it when the young boy for glad said father never used condom. You grown up people, tell me what I'm going to do. I know what I'm going to do. I know what I'm going to do. Say in it. I know what I'm going to say in it. Watch out! In a it, where you say put more in a it? More than before in a it? Where you say you're sure in a it? Put my train, me not drop on the floor. Say it now! Where you say put more in a it? More than before in a it? Where you say you're sure in a it? Put my train, me not drop on the one drop. Me make a tag, I'm a junk in a it. I wanna try take your room and get a funk in a it. Me not repeat no song. Level me, level me, level me. Me as the man them I use the bang of one and I scam people and I take them money. Me I use my bang of one, car God. When I want to see how my car God bang a bang of one, let me pull up the road. It already. Him just answer. I talk to you now. Yeah. Father above you no more for talk to you. You know how much demons me a walk from fear. You look a favor me a go pass one to you. It's a bummer me a use of the dark you see you. When you be round dark from a dark and free up with a walk man. Them a walk and play. Me took a break and the fans spark up a wait me and the mayor for the room me a want one state. Food up for eat, mommy want to complain. Forgive me enemies, them way you talk and eat. See the walking trophy, everyone fake. Them eat the most bun, every last one beat. Corona make me stagger, so my walk and shake. You have 1 minute remaining on this call. So no, me hear the girl about she and make me head here. Me borrow some credit and me now can't pay it. Hey, I got on the phone me a talk to. Two, if you want to know who me a talk to. Two, I got on the phone me a talk to. Read a chapter and chant one song. Two, I got on the Father, me man, my God, me start drink now. Wanna watch that? Me just get a link for the hotspot and never know say the bummer use what. Yo, my love with you, me not hold you, me not hold you.
One more round of applause for the brand, the Rumba.
We have representatives of the company, one of our major companies here, and is selling plantain chips. Could you tell us a bit more about this product and of course our CARICOM brothers and sisters?
CRISPR Planting Chips is a local planting chips manufacturer right here in Antigua and Barbuda. The company is locally owned by Antiguans and Barbudans, and it got started around 16 years ago in a kitchen, and then it graduated to a brand new state-of-the-art factory in 2019.
So what makes this so special?
Well, this planting chips is special because A, it got started by local Antiguans, and you know we can do cooking, and B, it got started in the kitchen of humble Antiguans, and then C, it has a secret ingredient which only one person knows. And also it is done with Antiguans and Barbudans and the wider Caribbean in mind when it is being produced. It is being produced in that category, that standard, so that we can have a Caribbean and Antiguan flavor at the same time.
Check out CRISPR planting chips. I've had them myself. They're really good. You're going to have them in savory or sweet, whatever your desire is. You already have your spicy, your salty, your sweet, and garlic, and spicy.
Sour cream
are coming soon. So be sure, by the next time we have another Caricom Friendship Day, we have a great variety of flavors. Yeah, isn't it?
Correct.
Wonderful. So we're going to leave the Christmas stand. We're going to go over to our friends from Cuba. Good afternoon. So what do we have here at the Cuban stand? Regina, can you tell us about what you have on offer?
We have Cuban soup.
What's in the Cuban soup? What makes it special?
The name in Cuba is caldosa.
Caldosa.
Yeah. It's like a soup.
Like a bull soup.
Ah.
Yeah.
So we can find some beef in here.
Yes. Sure.
Okay, so we have
many things inside.
Many different meats. Okay, so we have multiple meats in this Cuban soup yesterday that we can all try.
And provision ground too.
And provision and so on. Tell us a bit about this.
We have beef.
But the real name is vaca rebozada.
Vaca
rebozada.
Vaca rebozada.
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 It's a beef in some sauce.
Okay, so it's beef in sauce. And we have another delectable dish here.
Beef too, what we call ropa vieja.
Ropa vieja.
Ropa vieja.
The real name is ropa vieja.
Ropa vieja.
Rice and beef, we call congri. And we have cassava, we call yuca.
They're very friendly, as you can see. And we have a wide variety of other stalls here, both local and other members of the Caricom fraternity.
Hi, this is Sadie Christian of Earthly Instincts Original Art. And here we have an array of all handmade, 100% handmade local items, from pottery to contemporary and visual arts. You know, it's a pleasure being down here, and I hope everyone can come out and enjoy the day with us.
My name is Caroline Gopal. I have these pieces, kirba, centerpieces, pot soup, and beachwear, barefoot beach, and different runners, and many more. From I was going to secondary school back home in Jamaica, and I came to Antigua 30 years now, and I do this as a part-time. It's my hobby. Always have a passion craft.
Hi, I'm Natisha, owner and chemist at Zion Temple Care. We specialize in personal care products such as natural soaps, deodorants, body wash, body lotions, and facial products. You can contact us at 724-6502 if you're interested. That's 724-6502. Our products can also be found at Key Necessities on Lower Redcliffe Street. That's Key Necessities.
Hello, my name is Devonse Ralph, and I am the owner of Rael Collection, where I offer a wide variety of stationery and handmade journals, planners, and stationery items like paper clips and stickers. I started basically off of the love of writing stuff down, keeping notes, keeping organized, and just getting my thoughts out of my head and onto black and white on paper form. Business is going okay. I am fairly new. I started last year in 2020 when the peak of the pandemic started, and just wanted a way to get my vulnerability out to the public, let them know what I look like inside. And I want to believe in every journal or every planner that I have created, it's a little bit of me showing to the world, being shown to the world. So the colors, you know, different aspects.
My name is Ethel Thomas. I'm from that beautiful country of Dominica. I do crochet, I have hats, I have bags. I also do coconut oil, honey, and I'm doing my business since about 11 years now.
My name is Mitzi. We have coconut cake, which is $7, fruit cake, that is $5, plain cake, $5 we have. Marble slice, $5. Bun tart, $5. Cinnamon roll is $5. I have two different kind of currants roll, regular, and the wheat, $5 a piece. Meatball, sausage roll, patty, coconut pie, that's $7. Bread pudding and potato pudding, $7. Flat bread. $7 a half. Antigua crocodile. We are Mystic Baker catcher that first one come to Antigua. Cake tart, Massa Aris, Arshu, Kish. What is $3?
My name is Kevin Barnes. I'm representing Brandwood Care, BWC Enterprise, where we manufacture pure and infused coconut oil. We do coconut oil with a twist. We infuse various ingredients like turmeric, nutmeg. We even do the fruit flavors like pineapple, guava. And we have the byproducts for coconut, like the coconut crumbs, for example. So we're located in Skerritt's Pasture. It's 100% Antiguan product. My business came about because of adversity. Actually, I was struggling, battling with some health crisis. Not gonna state it really, but basically after I couldn't find or get no result in the medical fraternity, I started more research on coconut oil, and basically we came up with the turmeric infused and the nutmeg infused. And from since 2015, I haven't had an issue again, because what I did, consume the turmeric, it's anti-inflammatory, it really helped reduce chronic inflammation, get rid of excess mucus in the body also. So from that, we said, okay, if this can help me with my health issues, then we should bring it to the public. And basically, from ever since we launched our business in 2016, these products been helping a lot of people with ligament issue, bronchitis, for example, nerve issue, poor circulation, swelling, all type of issues like skin condition, dandruff. We also make the oils for cooking, like the chili pepper, the garlic, the ginger. These oils really help with the respiratory system, the digestive system, you know, the whole immune system overall. So basically, what we do now, we incorporate massages, right? Also, we have this device. This is called percussion massaging, right? So this device gets deep into the ligaments, the tissue, and release tension, knots, and stuff like that, right? It uses vibrational frequency. So people are suffering from ligament issue. Also, this help bring a lot of relief to them. We also do sessions like these that we incorporate the oil.
This is Ital World, all authentic Ital. We have natural sauce, we have rice and peas, we have chunks, and we have pasca. We have local juice, veggie burger, We're doing the jet bread there. This is Ital World. I get started about 96. We start in Benders, then we move to Jennings, Bowlands. We branch off. Sometimes it good, you can't complain. Most times it great for me.
My name is Karina Dean. I do homemade sauces. And these are sauces that you can use on your dishes. You could cook with them, or you can use them as they are, as salad dressing or complimentary sauces. Instead of having the regular ketchup, you can have any of these sauces with your fried food, your cooked food. And they're very delicious. And they're made locally. And the ingredients are sourced locally. They're vegan and vegetarian friendly. There are no animal products in any of my products.
Mary's Backyard Ornaments. I live in Antigua, but today I represent in Dominica. We have some lovely dolls, Dominica girls, classy girls. We also have some lovely Antigua girls. They are locally done by my hands. After the pandemic, I was home. I decided I have to do something. I'm a chef by profession. And then I started to make this craft. And people say they look good, so I just continue.
On behalf of the Ministry of Trade, in collaboration with the Department of Culture, we'd like to say a special thank you to the following individuals. Minister, the Honorable E.P. Chet Green, the Minister of Foreign Affairs, Trade and Immigration. Give him a round of applause. Also thanks to Ambassador Clarence Henry, Barbara Williams, Deputy National Authorizing Officer, Mr. Lyle Jackson, Youth Ambassador to CARICOM, Mr. Ken Cordes, our Director of Culture. Give him a round of applause. We also like to thank the staff of the Department of Culture, the media, all of today's service providers, the Cuban Embassy and Friends of Cuba, the Consulate of Jamaica and Friends of Jamaica, Dominica Association, Friends of Guyana, the Friends of Trinidad and Tobago, the people of Antigua and Barbuda, our exhibitors and our vendors, as well as our performers and participants.